Hi friends, I am Dr. Sharma and in this talk I will be dealing with what are the causes of red colored urine. The learning objective of this particular talk are to know the causes of red colored urine and to distinguish hematuria from the other causes which cause reddish discoloration of urine. Now let us first see what causes reddish discoloration of urine. It could be presence of RBCs, which is commonly termed as hematuria. It could be hemoglobinuria, myoglobinuria, dietary causes, poisons, and certain drugs. Now, beets and blackberries, because of the presence of anthocyanin as a compound in them, causes reddish discoloration of urine. Poisons like lead and mercury can cause red colored urine, but it has to be necessarily a chronic poisoning. Phenophthalein, a drug which is seen in bowel evacuants, phenothiazines and rifampicin are common drugs which cause red colored urine. Now, how to diagnose hematuria? This is important because hematuria is presence of RBCs and it may signify something sinister, and this needs to be distinguished from the other less sinister causes of reddish discoloration of urine. And the two tests which are very useful are urine microscopy and a dipstick test. On a urine microscopic examination, hematuria is defined as presence of more than 3 RBCs per high power field. Anything less than that is not termed as hematuria. The other way is to use a dipstick to diagnose this situation. Now, dipstick is a stick where there are multiple pads which can pick up presence of leukocytes, bacteria, pH, the proteins, as well as the presence of RBCs. The principle of dipstick is, the test pad has an organic peroxidase substrate called as tetramethylbenzidine. Now, when urine is having RBCs, the heme component from those RBCs causes oxidation. This causes color change, and the degree of color change is directly proportional to the amount of hemoglobin which is present in the urine. Now, if there is a positive dipstick test, it could be because of hematuria, hemoglobinuria, or myoglobinuria. Now, how to distinguish? Hemoglobinuria and myoglobinuria will cause a uniform color change. That is, the change on the pad will be uniform in its complete entirety, ranging from yellow through green to a strongly green-blue color, which is a strongly positive test. For hematuria, the positive test will be seen most of the times in the form of dots, that is, there is a speckled appearance and not a uniform appearance. And sometimes, if there are presence of more than 250 RBCs, then there might be coalescence of dots and it might give a more uniform color. Now, the sensitivity of the dipstick test when it comes to picking up hematuria is about 90%. High amounts of vitamin C may cause a false negative result, but the specificity of dipstick test is low. When I say the specificity is low, it means that there are number of situations where a false positive dipstick test can occur, especially when there is dehydration, which is likely to occur in the first morning voided specimen or following strong and very heavy exercise. So, if there is a positive dipstick test, friends, we need to distinguish hematuria from hemoglobinuria and myoglobinuria. Now, hematuria is easy to diagnose because RBCs will be seen in the urine on microscopic examination. Now, if RBCs are absent in urine and the dipstick test is positive, then the next thing would be examine the serum. Centrifuge the blood. In hemoglobinuria, the supernatant will be pink. Now, this happens because the free hemoglobin in the serum binds to haptoglobulin, which has a very high molecular weight and is water insoluble. So, this particular complex remains in the serum and causes pink discoloration. With myoglobinuria, the serum remains clear. The myoglobin has basically a low molecular weight and is water soluble. it does not bind to haptoglobulin and is excreted in urine, and hence the serum remains clear. So if the dipstick test is positive, do a urine microscopy. If the RBCs are seen, it is hematuria. If the RBCs are absent, centrifuge the blood, and if the serum shows pink discoloration, it is hemoglobinuria. If the serum remains clear, it is myoglobinuria. Thanks a lot, friends. For more such videos, log on to admedonline.com.